So in the proof of the theorem, we've defined 12 new variables, x1 through x12. Each variable represents the number of people in the group born during a particular month. So x1 is the number of people born in January, x2 the number of people born in February, x12 the number of people born in December. So we first argued that the total number of people has to equal the sum of all the variables. And this is because everyone is born in some month. So the total number of people is equal to the number of people born in January plus the number of people born in February, all the way up through the number of people born in December. Then what happens in the proof is a series of 12 substitutions that are actually all rolled into one line of the proof. So by assumption, there are no three people that are born all in the same month. So therefore, the number of people born in January, which we're representing by the variable x1, has to be at most two, because there can only be at most two people born in January. Similarly, the number of people born in February is at most two, all the way through December. So the first substitution that we make is we take this value, this variable x1, and we substitute 2 for x1 in this expression. And because 2 is at least as large as x1, the resulting sum after the substitution is at least as large as the sum I had before, because I'm taking this variable and substituting something that's greater than and equal to the value of the variable. So then we do a substitution again. This time we're going to replace x2 with the value of 2. So the 2 from before, and now we have the variable, the value of 2, which is replacing the variable x2, and the sum of the rest of the variables. And we keep repeating this process, and in each substitution, we replace one more variable with the upper bound of 2. And at the end, we have a sum of 12 2's in a row. And this is, of course, equal to 2 times 12, which has a value of 24. So the final expression that we end up with, which we know is equal to 24, is at least as large as the original sum that we had. And this is because in each of the substitutions, the value of the expression is either staying the same or getting larger. So the final expression has to be equal to or greater to the original expression. Now, the number of people is equal to the value of the sum of these variables, x1. And we've just shown that the value of this sum is less than or equal to the number 24. So therefore, the total number of people is less than or equal to 24. This contradicts the fact that the theorem says that the number of people in the group is 25. And so since we've obtained a contradiction, it cannot be the case that at most two people are born in each month, and therefore there must be some month in which at least three people were born.